Hi guys, so we are back with another song from Eminem. And which one are we doing today?
Today we're doing Come On Everybody. Do you know it?
I don't think so.
Okay.
Like for some reason I'm just thinking like everybody, come on. Oh wait, that's from like a commercial. Put a smile on. What is that? Is that like Goldfish?
Maybe. It might be.
It was like my first thought. I'm like, yeah, it's not Eminem. No. So no, I don't think so.
If I had to guess, I'd say most likely you don't know it. Maybe
Okay.
you'd recognize the chorus.
Is it everybody? Yeah. Come on.
It's Come On Everybody. So you'll see.
No.
And then before we do that song, we are going to do a skit that leads into it, which is Ken Kniff.
Is it as bad as the other one? Because I didn't like that.
No, this is a little different. It's kind of almost an origin of Ken Kniff.
Origin? Oh, okay.
Yeah.
His origin story.
Yeah.
Oh, right, because this is the technically before the last album.
Yes.
Okay.
All
right. Oh, and don't forget to like and subscribe and follow us on all social media channels. The description is down below. And if you don't feel like clicking on the links, just go to any social media channel and type in YOURE with Smith. That is our username.
Call this motherfucker. Oh, fuck yeah. Give him a piece of my mind. Piece of my ass.
Thank you for waiting. May I help you?
Oh, thank you. I need to make a collect call.
What number?
Oh, the number is 6. 2.
At the tone, please say your name.
Kenneth Kniff. From Connecticut. Automated piece of shit.
Yo.
Hey there, cock boy.
Who's this?
This is Ken Kniff.
Who?
Ken Kniff from Connecticut, little bitch.
From Connecticut?
Yeah, you wanna get
Nobody in Connecticut.
You wanna get a hotel room with me?
Oh, hotel room?
Yeah, you want me to lick your ass, Eminem?
Yo, who is this, Kate?
Hey, you want me to fucking melt in your mouth and not in your hand? Melt in your ass, you little cock boy.
Yo, shut up, you little bitch.
Oh, you think I'm lying, huh?
Wait, why does he sound exactly like the guy in Scream who...
He does sound like him.
Like, not in...
In the voice recording.
Yeah, like the one on the phone with Drew Barrymore.
Yeah.
That's so funny.
Yeah.
He sounds just like him.
Yeah, so that's...
Maybe he's using the same voiceover thing?
Maybe. So it sounds different. So, like, it's obviously Eminem on later albums.
Yeah.
So I don't know if that was him or not on this, like, or if he had a different person do it. I feel like I remember somebody claiming that Eminem stole the character Ken Kniff from him, but I'd never
really
looked into it. Yeah, so I'm not sure if that is actually Eminem or if it's somebody else doing it.
Interesting. If you guys know, mention it in the comments below.
Yes. All right. So now move
okay,
on to...
now we're going to Come On Everybody.
Yes, and it is spelled C-U-M.
Yeah, when you first... So wait, before we start, when you first said the title, like my mind initially went there because it just does.
It's titled,
so that's
yeah.
why I was like laughing. I was like, oh, that could be a double entendre. Like, let's go or like, come on, everybody.
Yeah, so it
so
is.
I figured it would be the latter with Eminem.
Yes, here we go.
Wait, I can't get it in. Okay, that's what she said. Okay.
Yo, mic check.
Woo.
Testing, 1, 2, 12.
What up, outsiders.
This is my dance song. Can
outsiders.
You hear me? Alright, take my headphones
like
up. My favorite color is red, like the bloodshed. From Kurt Cobain's head when he shot himself dead. Women all rapping in my shish kebab. Fort Lauren Hills tape so her kids could starve.
I can't
stand white
people.
Now I'm even more so. Shit, I got full-blown AIDS and a sore throat. I got a wardrobe with an orange robe. I'm in the fourth row, signing autographs to a show. I just remembered that I'm absent-minded. Wait, I mean I've lost my mind, I can't find it. I'm freestyling every verse that I spit. Cause I don't even remember the words to my shit. Told the doc I need a change in sickness. He gave a girl herpes and exchange for syphilis. Put my LP on your Christmas gift list. You wanna get high here, bitch, just sniff this. Come on, everybody.
Yeah, I've never heard this before. Not even like zero recognition.
Yeah, so I usually like to stop after the verse before the chorus, but the way it was flowing, I was like, oh, we got to let the chorus play so we can hear it.
Because I love Drug Ballad. Was that Dina?
It sounds like her. I believe it is.
Yeah.
I believe it's her. Yeah. Because she even did the, oh, shit, like the same thing that she does in the beginning of Drug Ballad.
Because if you guys watched our Drug Ballad reaction, or if you haven't, Drug Ballad was one of my favorite songs in high school. Yeah. I liked it a lot.
Yeah.
I don't really listen to much Eminem, but like that was a song that I really did like.
Yeah, for sure. So he starts the verse. My favorite color is red, like the bloodshed.
Good
from
color.
Kurt Cobain's head when he shot himself dead.
No, we love Kurt Cobain and Nirvana.
Yes.
And we still are not very sure if he did kill himself or not.
Yeah, who knows?
Conspiracy.
So I do like how many rhymes there are just in the first bar.
It's
red, shed, head, dead, you know.
Mm.
Women all grabbing at my shish kebab. Bought Lauryn Hill's tapes so our kids could starve.
I don't understand that.
Okay, so
why would her kids starve if you're buying her tape?
So I had to look into that.
Yeah, because like, wouldn't they be making money then?
So we spoke about on one of the recent reactions off the same album that there was, you know, a rumor that Lauryn Hill didn't like white people. So specifically what he's referring to is there was a quote that she supposedly said that was like, something like, I'd rather me and my kids starve than white people buy my music.
Interesting.
So,
wow.
So he said, bought Lauryn Hill's tape so her kids would starve. And then you hear, I can't stand white people. So again, he's going after her.
But we still don't know for sure that she said those things.
So I don't know.
I don't know
might know whether it's true or false, you know.
Yeah. If you guys know, throw it in the comments, I guess.
Yeah. So then he says, you thought I was ill, and now I'm even more so. Shit, I got full-blown AIDS and a sore throat.
And that's a good double entendre, that you thought I was ill, and now I'm even more so.
Exactly.
Like, you thought I was cool, or you thought I was, like, ill.
Exactly. And then AIDS and then a sore throat, which is funny.
He's rapped about AIDS before, but that was, like, a big thing back then.
Yeah. I got a wardrobe with an orange robe. I'm in the fourth row signing autographs at your show.
When he says an orange robe, does that mean like from being in prison?
So it's a robe. So,
but that just rhymes with wardrobe. So like, could it be? Or is he just...
I suppose it's possible. I never actually looked into it. So yeah, I know what you're thinking. Like the orange jumpsuit.
Yeah.
Yeah. So maybe. I do like I'm in the fourth row signing autographs at your show.
That's so funny. Because was he even that big at this point? Was he?
No. So this is his first album with, you know, Dr. Dre.
So that's funny.
And then he says, I just remember that I'm absent-minded. Wait, I mean, I've lost my mind. I can't find it.
That's funny.
It's my favorite line in the song.
Yeah, it's a good one.
Yeah.
For sure.
Yeah, because, you know, absent-minded means you're forgetful.
Mm-hmm.
And then he's literally changing it to that he doesn't know where it is.
Yeah, because then you can look at that as a double entendre too, like absent-minded.
Exactly. Yeah.
Like your mind is gone.
For sure.
You can't find it.
Mm-hmm. I'm freestyling every verse that I spit because I don't even remember the words to my shit, which is funny.
That's like Justin Bieber when he sang Despacito live for the first time.
Oh, yeah.
He like forgot all the words and he's like, I don't know the words, so I say burrito. And like he was just singing like that. For the whole thing, you guys should check it out. It's pretty funny.
It is funny. I told the doc I need a change in sickness and gave a girl herpes in exchange for syphilis. Put my LP on your Christmas gift list. You want to get high here, bitch, just sniff this. And then the chorus, come on everybody.
Yeah, never heard this before.
All right, so we will keep going here.
Try suicide once. once and I'll try it again. That's why I write songs where I die at the end. Cause I don't give a fuck, like my middle finger was stuck. And I was waving it at everybody screaming I suck. I go on stage in front of a sellout crowd and yell out loud, all y'all get the hell out now. Fuck rap, I'm giving it up y'all, I'm sorry.
Eminem, this is your record release party.
I'm bored out of my gourd, so I took a hammer and nailed my foot to the floorboard of my Ford. Guess I'm just a sick, sick bastard. Just one sandwich short of a picnic basket. One Excedrin tablet short of a full medicine cabinet. I feel like my head has been shredded like lettuce and cabbage. And if you ever see a video for this shit, I'll probably be dressed up like a mummy with my wrist slit. Come on, everybody.
That was really good. I think, I know you said your that other line before. I totally forgot what it was your favorite, but like that was a really good line.
Yeah, no, this is a sick verse. This is, I mean, so.
The picnic basket and then the cabbage, the lettuce.
Yeah, so as a verse, I think this verse is way better than the first verse. I just really like that line about being absent-minded.
Yeah.
So he says, I tried suicide once and I'll try it again.
That's funny.
That's why I write songs where I die at the end. Because I don't give a fuck, like my middle finger was stuck, and I was waving at everybody screaming, I suck. And then you hear in the background,
them all screaming,
I suck. Yeah.
So then he's like, he's waving at everyone who's saying, I suck, like meaning like Eminem, you suck. But then he's the one who's saying, I suck, like he sucks.
Yeah, it's funny.
It's funny.
Gotta go back here. I go on stage in front of a sellout crowd and yell out loud, all of y'all get the fuck out now. Fuck rap. I'm giving it up, y'all. I'm sorry. But Eminem, this is your record release party.
That's really funny.
Yeah, that's hysterical. Like, quitting at like, your record release party.
I mean, well, you made party. It. Now you can go and chill, I guess.
True.
Not really, though.
Yeah. He says, I'm bored out of my gourd, so I took a hammer and nailed my foot to the floorboard of my Ford. I love the way that line sounds. Yeah. You know? Guess I'm just a sick, sick bastard. One who's one sandwich short
of a picnic basket. Yes,
can't even read right now.
Which is funny. I've heard that saying before.
Yes, that is a good one. And then he carries it on. One Excedrin tablet short of a full medicine cabinet. I feel
just
like
just one.
Yes. that is funny. I feel like my head has been shredded like lettuce and cabbage. And if you ever see a video for this shit, I'll probably be dressed up like a mummy with my wrist slit.
Is there a video and is he dressed up like that?
So I don't think I've seen a video to this song. I don't believe it exists.
If you guys know, let us know.
I don't think so, but if it does,
I would be surprised because of just the title. Like, I don't think he expected this to get, like, you know,
radio
MTV music video channel status.
Keep going here.
Probably be dressed up like a mummy with my wrist slit. Come on, everybody.
Get down tonight.
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 Got bitches on my dock out in East Detroit. Cause they think that I'm a motherfucking Beastie Boy. So I told them I was Mike D. It was like,
gee, I don't know who Mike B.
I told them, meet me at Kid Rock's next concert. I'll be standing by the Loch Ness Monster. Did it to the weed house. Smoked out till I started busting freestyles. Broke out, then I dipped quick. Back to the crib, put on lipstick. Crust up the Tylenol and ate it with a dipstick. Made a couple of crank calls, collect. I wanna make songs all the fellas dub. And murder every rich rapper that I'm jealous of. So just remember when I bomb your set. Yo, I only cuss to make your mom upset. Come on, everybody.
I like that verse too.
Yeah, that was pretty funny.
Yes, so he starts off, got bitches on my jock out in East Detroit because they think that I'm a motherfucking Beastie Boy.
I love the Beastie Boys.
Yeah, so he says, so I told them I was Mike D from the Beastie Boys, obviously. They was like, gee, I don't know, he might be.
Of course, because like...
It's a white rapper.
Yeah.
Yeah. I told them, meet me at Kid Rock's next concert.
Love him too.
I'll be standing next to the Loch Ness Monster. It's so funny.
Yeah.
Peace out. Then I jetted to the weed house, smoked out till I started busting freestyles, broke out. So I like the peace out, jetted to the weed house, smoked out, and then started busting freestyles, broke out. So like, you know, the rhyming of, you know, the weed house, freestyles, and then smoked out, broke out.
Mm-hmm.
It's kind of cool how he did that.
Yeah, I like that.
Yeah. And then he says, then I dipped quick back to the crib, put on lipstick, crushed up the Tylenol, and ate it with a dipstick.
What's a dipstick?
Like the candy.
Oh, okay.
Or
is he talking about like his engine oil?
So he could be talking to that. I never thought about that. That might be. I don't know.
Because that stuff, I don't think that was called a dipstick. It was called like.
The candy, I believe, was called dipstick.
It was.
But it could be, I don't know, it could be a car, you know, oil.
Yeah. Or
it could be the candy.
That would be funny.
Because if you're crushing up the Tylenol, it's a powder, like the candy, you know what I mean?
Yeah, you're right.
I don't know, though, you know.
That was such a crazy candy. It was literally like pure sugar, like a stick of pure sugar, and then sour pure sugar. And sometimes it was just the sweet powder. So you just have like.
Yeah.
I loved it.
That's so funny. So ate it with a dipstick, made a couple of crank calls, collect. It's Ken Kniff from Connecticut. Can you accept? So there's a little more Ken Kniff. I'm wondering if like if he made this song first and then did the skit, or they did the skit and then he included this into the song. You know what I mean?
I see.
Because the Ken Kniff skit that we just listened to was the song, you know, right before this.
Yeah. Maybe he made the song first.
Maybe.
And then he was like, oh, that'd be a good skit to put there.
Yeah, so there's context for who Ken Kniff is.
Yeah.
And then he says, I want to make songs all the fellas dub and murder every rich rapper that I'm jealous of. So, yeah, you know, dub. You know what I mean? Like record.
Yeah,
like,
record over.
Yeah, remix, all that shit. Mm-hmm. Yeah. So just remember when I bomb your set, yo, I only cuss to make your mom upset, which is pretty funny.
And my mom was definitely very upset.
Right, keep going here. To make your mom upset. Come on, everybody. Get down tonight. 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 Come on, everybody.
That was fun.
Yes.
That was definitely a fun one.
Yes.
I like dancing to it. I was like, oh, this is fun. It's like, come on, buddy.
Yeah, it was a...
I like dancing to the fun, like, dancing like one.
Yeah, it is a dancey one.
And yeah.
I believe it was Dina Ray again.
Yeah, it sounded just like her in Drug Ballad.
Yeah. So, you like it?
Yeah, I can appreciate it. I would say, like, I like it, but I feel like... It's definitely not my favorite, but I liked it. And the second verse, I think.
Yeah.
That was really good.
Yeah, that was very good.
Yeah.
Yeah, I like the song too. It's funny.
Yeah, it's funny. It's too much of a funny song for me to say is the best. You know what I mean? Yeah, but yeah. I did like dancing to it, and I like the verses.
Yeah.
For sure.
Yeah, no, I love this song. There's lyrically, it's awesome. You know, there's a bunch of good bars in here.
Yeah, it is.
Yeah, the title, the whole chorus being a double entendre is funny. Yeah, when I actually was trying to pull this up for us to do this video, I started typing it in and on YouTube, and it wouldn't autofill because it's spelt like that, you know, C-U-M. So, like, nothing came up when I typed that in as a suggestion, which is really funny. That's
funny.
Yeah. All right.
Well, don't forget to like and subscribe, and we'll see you guys tomorrow.
See you soon.